This is the Marketplace.
Hi, folks. Welcome to the Marketplace. And today we're on location at the Relay for Life 2017 Relay for Life event here in St. Croix. And I'm going to have an opportunity to really engage and kind of get the story of some of the cancer survivors here at this event. And this is important because when you think of the Marketplace, we tend to span the life and events of just ordinary folks, everyday folks like you, like me, where our lives are affected on such, on many different levels, on many different fronts. And all of us have a story to tell. And today we're going to have an opportunity to really find out what is the impact, how is cancer really impacting the lives of the people that we know and we love and that are dear to us. And so my name is Anthony Weeks, and I'm here with two cancer survivors, and we're going to have an opportunity to hear their story and the work that they're doing in terms of their outreach and trying to build awareness and education as it relates to the issue of cancer and its impact. But before I do that, let me just kind of give you a sense of the financial impact of cancer. The economic impact of cancer, the financial costs of cancer are high for both the person with cancer and for society as a whole. The Agency for Healthcare Research and Quality estimates that the direct medical cost total of all healthcare costs for cancer in the U.S. in 2014 were $87.8 billion in that as reported as of April 14, 2017. I have with me Yvonne Gallagher. She is the founder and the CEO of the YAG Foundation. And Yvonne, welcome to the Marketplace.
Thank you for having me.
All right, thank you for accepting our invitation to be part of the program. And so you have an opportunity to share your story and the work that you're doing and the fact that you are a survivor.
Yes.
With folks throughout the country, throughout the Caribbean and South America. Mm-hmm. And what would you say to folks, I mean, in terms of what really inspired you to do what you do? Kind of just take us back from the beginning.
All right.
And lead us to the present.
Okay.
Music in motion. Put your hands together one more time for music in motion.
It was very easy. I was diagnosed in 2005. And when I went through my breast cancer, I was at stage 2. And I went home for treatment to Connecticut. We have insurance, and I went home because I had to have chemotherapy as well as radiation. So therefore, I had to stay for 6 months with my parents in Norwalk, Connecticut. My daughter was 8 at the time. We had to uproot her, and she had to go to school there as well. As I was finishing my chemo and started my radiation, it gave me time to really think once I realized that this chapter was ending, because that's all you knew at this point. You're just going through your chemo, you're meeting new friends, you meet so many people with different walks of life, different types of cancer, and I just wanted to give back. I was laying in bed after my last radiation, and I'm like, you have a new chapter. And that new chapter was for me to come back to St. Croix and to establish a foundation to help women and men in need that do not have medical insurance, that are medically uninsured. And that's what we've been doing for 10 years. It's our 10-year anniversary, and we're very happy. We're getting acknowledged and recognized, and we've been doing a lot. We advocate here in the community. We speak at churches. We speak at schools. We have Beauty in the Bra, which is a fun fundraiser. We have our annual Breast Cancer Awareness Conference at UVI, which will be in November. And it's just very rewarding to give back. So we're very pleased.
And what kind of reception are you getting from
the community? Is very warm, but there's a lot of women that still aren't ready to share their journey. And it's very hard to get men to discuss their journey. They want to forget about it. Or they may share it with me, but they don't want to share it with anyone. You know? So a lot of it is still taboo to a lot of people, especially the older generation.
Now, to our right, we have someone who's also a cancer survivor.
And this is my friend.
Yes. How are you? Okay. Now, you know,
Javon.
Yes, Javon. You know, I've known you for a while. Did not know you were a cancer survivor, and I just find it incredible that I've interacted with you on so many levels, and you never once revealed that you were a cancer survivor. So when I found that you were a cancer survivor, I was like, no, I can't believe it. So is that cancer for you? Is that something that you? Is it a private matter? Is it something that you want to share with others? I mean, tell us a little bit about how you feel yourself.
I guess with me, the only thing is that with me about with my cancer is that, you know, when you tell somebody you have cancer, the first thing they give you is the, you know, and I don't like that.
Okay.
I don't want anybody to feel sorry for me because I had cancer. So that's really the main reason why I don't really share it or, like, you know, come out and open about, me having cancer. If it comes up in a conversation, then I'll be like, oh, yeah, you know, I'm a survivor and, I went through this. I was diagnosed in about 2006. But I don't really talk about it that much because I don't really feel like it was a big thing. You know what I'm saying? Cancer is a big thing, but I really didn't feel for myself personally that it was a big thing.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow. If I can just be transparent for a second. In my family, I mean,
put your hands together for music in motion. I think that deserves an extra round of applause because they were in the dirt and they still dance. I give them an extra round of applause.
One of my niece, she's a survivor and she's a breast cancer survivor. So cancer is quite, if you will, prevalent in my family. So when you say it's not a big deal, I'm like,
we are gonna ask everyone to please clear the tracks.
Just keep it a little bit too long.
We are about to have the survivor walk. So if you are not in a purple shirt, please remove yourself from the track at this time. We are going to have our survivor walk. Our survivors are lining up at this moment.
So to me,
if you are not in a purple shirt,
but as
please
you get older, you meet more people and
excuse
you
us
hear more about it, and you have
a short while
and family members that are being diagnosed as well. And it's becoming very scary.
This is the Marketplace. We'll be right back.